press the bell icon on our YouTube app and never miss another video from SpotboyE.
Here's Juhi Parmar with us, with SpotboyE, on her first interview as a single parent.
Yeah.
Welcome to SpotboyE, Juhi.
Thank you, Vicky.
I know it's been very tough for you the last few months, in fact, the last few years. And I really wish to know, like, how has life changed, first and foremost, after being a single parent?
Being a single parent is definitely tough, because when you call single parent means you are parenting completely all on your own. But that also means love coming double from the child for you. So that love and that force keeps you going. I wouldn't say single parenting has just started. I have been a single parent for quite some time now. Especially for the past 2 years when I was working. So I wouldn't say that now it has changed. Now, in fact, I'm kind of getting into the flow of being a single parent and getting used to the whole fact.
Hmm.
And yes, I don't know how tough it is, because every day you come up with new challenges. But if it has become easier to be able to be a single parent, it's only because of the support that I have around me, especially my parents, my sister, and some friends like Ashka, who is a sister to me. I don't know if I should call her a friend or a sister, so she is a sister to me. And there are some other friends who have been really there, like strong pillars in my life. So they are the ones who have really made it easy for me to be able to cope with it, to be able to be there for Samaira, give my 200%, because now it's not just about being a mother,
yeah,
but being a father and mother to your child. Mm.
But your parents were in Jaipur, right?
Yeah.
So
my dad was working with Raymond's, and he got promoted and shifted to Mumbai in 2011, I think he got promoted and shifted here. And he got retired in August 2016. So my dad, after retirement, my mom and dad were to go back to Jaipur. But I have no words how to thank them, because they changed their lives 360 degrees for me.
Mm.
They stayed back in Mumbai. They said that you go out there, work. We will make sure that Samaira is taken care of. And that's how I was able to take this call of getting back to work. And I started shooting for Shani. And since then, it's been, I would say, I am Samaira's parent. But for past 2 years, my parents stepped into the shoes of parents from grandparents. Because I used to be practically in Umargaon till the time Shani was on. So, yeah, they really changed their lives for me.
But were you not tense that, you know, until they actually changed their lives, that, you know, how will you manage? Because how will you actually report to the set? Samaira is just 5.
It was not about how will I get back to work. I was very sure I will not get back to work.
Oh.
I had told them that come what may, I am not leaving my child with house helps. A, you get to hear such horrible stories everywhere. Secondly, I'm a very, very, very obsessed mother. Like, I'm sure all mothers are obsessed.
Very indulgent.
But I am like, it's all about Samaira for me now. So, I could not have even imagined leaving my child with a caretaker at home and go to work.
Mm.
There has to be somebody from the family, because the way they love, they are not taking care of your child because they are being paid for it.
Yeah.
They are doing it because they love your child. So there is a huge difference in that. So yeah, when this whole big event that was happening in my life, when I decided that okay, now I am going to end the marriage and I am going to be a solo, single woman, single parent, there was no question I could have left her alone. And working is important. It's not just necessary, it is important. I love working. I am an actor. It's my passion. I would have given up all of that. So my parents understood that, and that was when they said that, no, you don't have to do it. You are a good actor.
Samaira is going to be very proud of you when she grows up.
Thank you for saying that. Like, I am very proud of my parents, that they are my parents, because they said that you don't have to worry about Samaira. She's in safe hands. We have brought you up. We can definitely bring up your daughter, but you're there. It's just that we will be there in your shoes when you're not around. So I don't know how many nights they must have not slept when Samaira was not well. How many nights they have just sponged her so that the fever comes down. They taking her to school, bringing her back from school. My father attends parent-teacher meeting when I was shooting for Shani. It was my father who has attended all the PTMs. Mm. So, you know, my mom and my dad have been there like angels and guardians around Samaira, taking care of her completely so that I can work at peace. And I must say here that apart from my parents, my Shani team has really helped me to cope with this whole phase, because that was the time when it came out and people around me started getting to know that, okay, I'm going through.
Did you keep that, what you defined as big event in your life, procrastinating it a little bit because of Samaira?
Yes, somewhere, yes. You do. You do that for the child. You have to. Whenever you take a decision, and in my case, and I'm sure in most of the mother's case, you always take a decision keeping your child in mind first. Mm. So yes, everything is around the child. Good, bad, no, yes, everything depends on the child. I kept delaying it also for her because I kept thinking, will it be the right decision for her? But then when I felt that this is the right decision, yes, I took it up. And when there came a time when my production people, my shooting people, they needed to know that what's the reason why I need to rush back to Mumbai all the time? Why am I always so worried about my child? Why am I always wanting that, you know, if my child is not well, I would say I want to go back. If this has happened, I want to go back. I want to be in Mumbai. So obviously they would feel that, okay, her father is there. Why do you have to worry so much? And that's when they realize that, no, there's something going on in
her
life.
You told them.
And I had to tell them that, listen, I'm going through this thing where my marriage is going to be, I'm officially ending it, and it's me and my parents. So at that time, the way they adjusted for me, mostly it doesn't happen. Like, we work in an industry where people only think of the deadlines of the show, the deliveries of your episodes. But I was working with some really good-hearted set of people, and which started from the producer of the show, Siddharth, who really understood. He is a father himself. So he understands what a parent feels for the child. So every time there was a situation where I needed time off, they really bent backwards, adjusted for me, how they managed to shoot the scenes, would send me back. The car would be available. Okay, go, come back, go. I've done to and fro to Margao when Samaira has not been well. So yeah, it's not just one set of people who helps you. It is, I think, God, when wants to make you sail through a situation, he brings those kind of people and that
elements
kind of support
around
and elements around you that just you
ho jata hai.
Bas ho jata hai. And wo ho gaya.
But did the child, who is the main fulcrum here, did not ask once in a way or maybe more than once that where is dad, why is only mommy around, why?
See, these kind of questions are quite obvious. But most importantly, when I started working again, Samaira was just 3.5. And before that also, there were many times when it was just me around her. So Samaira is, most of the times, from the beginning, used to seeing mother around more. In any case, kids are very attached to mothers. It's the umbilical cord or what, I don't know. But it's just that the mother, the kids are more about the mother till a particular age.
Yeah.
But in my case, she is a total mama's girl. In fact, like how Shani was for Mata. Like when we used to shoot, my shooting people used to say that you have Shani on screen and you have a Shani like.
You took her on the set sometimes?
Yeah, yeah. She used to come to the set. She used to love coming to Margaon. She used to love spending time with the people there. Play with Shani, play with the Yummy. She knows them by their character names only. So she used to have a great time. But Samaira is a very understanding kid. And not just understanding. I am thankful to her that she has made this whole process easier for me by not asking so many questions. You know, I think I've...
Not even to your mother and father?
No.
In your absence?
No. Her only question used to be, when would mamma come? Mamma chahiye is what she says now, is what she used to say then. I want mamma, mamma chahiye. So, the only question my parents had to face and kind of manau her
deal
around
it
and deal with it was that mamma will come back in 2 days, mamma will come back in 1 day. I will speak to her, I'll try to take an adjustment, go for half a day, do anything, because her whole focus was, I want my mom around. Samaira really made it easy for me by not making me uncomfortable, by asking those questions which would make me feel
guilty.
Should I do it or no? Is it right or wrong? Should I think again? I would still think, being a mother, I would still think from her point of view and think that I hope I'm doing right. Yes. But I'm really thankful to her for being that kind of a child who just understood. She's divine. She just understood it on.
But
a
from what
level.
I know, and I know for a fact that the father was running away for 3 months, 4 months, and never around, often never around, and you were still the single parent then.
You seem to know a lot. But regarding this, whatever I had to say, I think my open letter is out there for everyone to read, and. I think I've said all that I wanted to say, in this regard at least.
So hereafter, what is it? Does it make you wary of men? Can I ask you that?
No.
Does it make you wary of falling in love again? Does it make you wary of...
I think it will be very...
Or is it going to be single, Juhi? Any decision taken?
Very, very wrong on my part if I start...
Getting cynical?
And I become judgmental about this beautiful emotion called love. I become judgmental towards men because I have had some fantastic men in my life in different form of relations, be it a brother, be it a friend, be it my father, who have been so supportive. I have some friends who are fantastic fathers, fantastic husbands. How can I take that away from them because of my own experience, whatever happened in my life?
Mm.
So yes, I will never get into that that cynical
space
where I would say, no, I am anti this or anti that. No, I want to move out and go ahead in life with my daughter, holding her hand tight and looking at life positively.
So Juhi can fall in love again.
There has to be somebody out there who has to make me fall in love again. I am sure God is watching out there. Right now, I am in love with my daughter completely. But...
That man has to fall in love with you and your daughter for sure.
For sure.
Otherwise, he's not coming in, obviously.
Obviously. That goes without saying. Now, Juhi is a package deal.
Yeah.
Juhi and Samaira are one. So, yeah, but I cannot say that I have lost faith in love or... at all. I cannot be like that. Then it will become too difficult. Then I'm living with I'm infusing a lot of negativity in me, and I don't want to go move ahead with negativity. I have taken this decision because I want to be happy, because I want to be positive.
You look happy.
Yes. And I'm thankful to the people around me. I'm really, really thankful for the peace in my life, for the cheerfulness, the happiness, everything that is there. I'm thankful to God for everything.
But were there days when finally everything was, you became a single parent officially, and few 6-7 days, did I do the right thing still?
That's what I'm saying.
Did that initial, you know?
See, that's what
I mean.
Saying,
when you join a new office, you think about it, you know, have I done the right
thing?
That's
what I'm saying. When you say officially, it is like, okay, now... I am going to experience this. When you join an office, you imagine that how would joining office be? And when you join the office, you feel, okay, this is how the office is. Mm-hmm. Whereas in my case, as I said, I was already living the life of a single parent for a very long time. So when this happened officially, by then I was already used to it. It was just one day which came and went.
Were you at any point worried when the proceedings were going on that the custody of the child, about the custody of the child?
No, there was no worry about that because we had a mutual divorce and obviously it was from the day one decided Samaira is going to be with me. There was no question about it.
There was no fight over it.
There was no fight over it. It was decided from the day one.
I would say it's very shocking that a man is so detached from his child, whether it's a son or a daughter.
Well,
I mean,
again, I would say I don't want to say anything on that. That's your take.
No, I'm telling you as my own take because I have two kids of my own and this is, if I can't imagine life without my kids or even being away from them. I mean, it's not without.
I can't imagine my life without my child. I know that. I can't imagine a day without her. First thing in the morning I want to see is her face. I want to go off to sleep holding her tight. Mm. In the middle of the night, in my sleep also, I want to touch
she's
her, feel
where
her,
is she, huh?
Experience that she's there next to me. So, I know about that. I don't know about the other side. I'm nobody to speak from the other person's point of view or anything. But yes, from my side, I know that yes, Samaira is my world. I can't imagine a day without
How her. Have the parents taken it? Your parents?
I'm proud of my parents.
We got into that, but how have they taken it? I mean, do they?
That's what I'm saying.
Do they tell you that you did the right? You know.
That's what I'm saying. I'm so proud of them that they have been such today's strong parents. They have not been the kind of parents who would
allow the daughter to take any shit
and suffer.
Yeah.
They were always the ones who have always told me, "We are with you. We want to see you happy. Whatever makes you happy." And of course, whatever happened in the course of marriage, they know all of it.
But shuru mein bhi unki taraf se koi aisa nahi tha, chalao, you know, we don't, you have a child, you know.
All those things were mine.
Yeah.
It was not theirs.
Yeah. So they are very progressive.
I took time to even tell them that there is a problem. Okay. They did not know. For a very long time, nobody knew. So they
couldn't sense it when they came to your house or...
Yeah, but like how? Every couple would have some problems sometime and all. Off and on, chota mota bata diya. But not to the extent where they would know that there are such big issues.
Hmm.
So this thing of for Samaira was from my side. I used to go through it. I used to have this... Atma manthan, jise aap kehte hain.
So apne aap ko tayyar karna, phir unko batana. The whole thing you have done.
Yeah. Of course, it is not. It cannot be a happy decision for any parents. They can never be happy about the fact that their child, be it a daughter or a son, is deciding to end the marriage they are into, and especially when she or he has a child. But I think it's all about seeing what is good for your child.
Would it have been easier and faster if you were not a mother and just a wife?
I don't know. Maybe, yes. Maybe, yeah.
On the work front now?
On the work front, I've just finished this show and I'm really, really enjoying my time with Samaira. I can't seem to feel full.
And you are positive. I mean, are we all serious?
Work, though, I have to work. There's no way I will not work.
No, but you don't want to get into it like 2-3 serials or...
No. I'm done with all that. Huh. I cannot be doing 2-3 serials because now I am not just an actor. I am a mother first and then an actor.
You have to balance that.
And more than balance, the weightage has to be on my daughter's side. So I have to take up work which is going to allow me...
To prioritize
and give time...
Samaira over.
To Samaira. Anytime. But yes, not working is not an option for two reasons. One, as I said, that I love working. I want Samaira to see her mother working. I want her to grow up knowing that working is so good for yourself. Working gives you a focus in life. Working keeps you constructive in life. And I want her to grow up into a strong,
independent girl. This decision also is coming from the financial independence you have, the strength you have, the mental strength it has given you.
Yeah.
So are you open to also doing films, web shows?
It all depends on the kind of role that is offered to me. So I am an actor and it really doesn't matter which platform it is. be it theatre, films, web series, anywhere. I just want to act. I want to do good roles. Something that's going to excite me. Something that's going to make me feel good and add to my profile that, okay, this I have done. I'm proud of my body of work that I have done till now. And I hope that I keep adding more feathers to my hat.
Very important to ask you, how do you see television now? Because you have done television when, you know, five or seven of you were household names. I mean, whether it was Sakshi, Smriti, yourself, Amna, household names, you know. Like, now it is very different.
Yeah.
I rarely see somebody, you know, being spoken about in that vein. How do you see television? Do you think television has grown? Do you think it has become watered? Kya ho raha hai?
See, television
or kyun ho raha hai, jo bhi ho raha hai.
Grown definitely in the sense that there is more work for sure. There are more shows being made. There are more channels. So, people who want to act have got more
opportunities.
The time you are talking about, there were these shows which were going on for 6 years, 7 years. So, for 7 years, one slot is given to a show and obviously there are 20 other actors waiting to get work.
Yeah.
Now a show doesn't, there are so many shows, they don't even last for more than 3 months.
3 months, yeah.
So if a show has lasted 2 years, 3 years, it's a big thing.
Yeah.
So in a time like that, yeah, you do not go on to become iconic characters the way we had become, and we were lucky to be a part of television at that time when we became icons. But it will be very difficult to categorize it that has it grown or no. It has, everything has its own pros and cons, I would say that. It has definitely grown in a certain way.
But that's the volume. I'm talking about the quality.
Quality again, then, there are some shows, without naming them, there have been very regressive shows. But then there are some very, very progressive shows too. So there is always a balance. It's not that, like, for example, Kumkum. Saas Bahu drama, you slot it. But Kumkum was, I think, one of the most progressive shows because it was about a young widow who goes on to get married and move on in life. So it was a progressive thought. It was not that, oh my God, a girl at the age of 21 has become a widow and she should sit at home and cry. No, the message that was sent out was that she has the right to live her life again.
Yeah.
And then she faced whichever struggle she faced in life. So it's not that then progressive shows were not made, but then there were regressive shows then also. So today also, as the volume has gone up, maybe the volume of the regressive and progressive also gone up.
Do you see that much talent?
It will be very wrong and unfair on my part to judge anybody. And honestly, I don't even get to watch television to be able to say that. Because when I switch on the TV, I have to watch Dora. I have to watch Mickey Mouse. I have to watch Shimmer and Shine. So I can
here talk also Samaira takes
more about, yes. So I can talk more about the Barbies and the Elsas and the Annas and the Shimmer and Shines.
Yeah, but from what I get to see, and I'm also an avid watcher of television, I still see, in fact, I don't see that talent. Because what I believe is that, you know, younger artists are coming at reduced rates and compared to what they were earlier with the era. And koi bhi aa jata hai, koi kisi se bhi, koi bhi chal jata hai hero, koi bhi heroine ban. It's become very watered, you know. It's not that this person can act, this person can hold the show for 2 years. I'm not even talking about seven. So, ye na sahi to wo sahi, it's okay. Because the rates are also very, of course, they are not that what if you were to pay daily on that day and today, is of course, proportionally today. But it's become, you know, replaceable, dispensable. I have had chats with senior actors. They say, we can't compromise on the money which we are being given.
Obviously, you can't.
We are being given today.
No. You can't compromise because you have reached a position after a lot of hard work.
Yeah.
So today, if you get a call where they expect you to work on a certain price just because you are getting to play the main lead, no, it doesn't work that way.
Yeah.
Because we have really worked hard to make a name of that stature where you can demand a certain amount of money. So obviously, and then you command that kind of money also.
Yeah.
So obviously, there are a lot of actors who do not want to compromise. I think here I would only say that I have been extremely lucky. And like you're saying that the actors, then I'm not saying that people are not talented. No, obviously there is a lot of talent in many ways, be it dancers, actors, singers. But yeah, the way we became, as I said, iconic characters, then I'm thankful that I am one of those names which are remembered even today. I go anywhere, like here, when I was coming here outside, there was somebody who just saw and said that she's Kumkum, and she said Juhi Parmar. So I'm thankful to God that I belong to the time where my character is also remembered and my name is also remembered.
Yeah, but today, as I said to you in a mall, a girl working in a TV serial is standing and you don't recognize her.
Well, then I can only say thank you, God.
It's time to say thanks to you. Thank you so much for being on SpotBoy. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you,
Juhi.